But here is the breaking news that's coming in at the moment, because this could be some good news for India and the world. Russia has just approved a single-dose Sputnik Light COVID vaccine. It's a revolutionary one-shot COVID-19 vaccine with an 80% efficacy, higher than many two-shot vaccines. Sputnik Light is to double the rate of the vaccination process. That's the big story that's coming in at the moment. A short while ago, Russia making that announcement. Let's go across to Sneha Morjani, who joins us at the moment for the very latest. Sneha, give us more details, because presumably India already has got is getting doses of the Sputnik V vaccine, which is already coming to India in tandem with Dr. Reddy's laboratories. This is a new vaccine.
Yes, in that sense, it's a tried and tested platform. So there is little concern when it comes to the novelty of this. It's the adenovirus platform. We already have given the approval for Sputnik V, but the double dose vaccine. If the approvals come through in India as well, then it's going to make just life so much more easier, given the fact that it's a struggle right now in India for those who've got the first dose to then go back and get the second dose of the vaccine. So Rajdeep, logistically it's going to be extremely easy, but remember, there has to be a separate set of approval for Sputnik V Lite. It's not the same as Sputnik V, the double dose vaccine. In fact, Russia too did the studies for the same between December and April, and then there are a couple of other countries also, like the UAE, for example, Ghana, and many others who have done trials for this. The results are expected by the end of May. So the process is going to be as follows. India and RDIF already are in conversation, and Sputnik V's doses, 1.5 lakh, have already come to the country. There's going to be a separate application that's going to be made to the regulators for approval of this single dose vaccine, which of course, like you mentioned, is showing efficacy of close to 80%. Good enough, at least for the time being, given the fact, like I said, because it's a tried and tested platform of the adenovirus platform. If the approvals come through, and if India takes the route that it has promised to, in the sense, give the approval within 3 days and allow these companies to carry on bridging studies at the same time to ensure more doses, then in just maybe a couple of weeks or you know, in just some time from now, I really can't give you a timeline, but I think it's a possibility that this vaccine could be introduced in India as well.
Because, Sneha, one of the concerns has been the delays in granting approvals. Now, last month, the Prime Minister said that this entire process would be expedited, and signals were clearly sent out after review that India would be much more open to taking in global vaccines, whether it's Pfizer, whether it's Moderna, and indeed Sputnik. So is there a sense of urgency now that we are witnessing, possibly to bring in these foreign vaccines, so that we are not just reliant on Covishield and Covaxin?
Yes, absolutely. A sense of urgency, but there are hindrances as well. With Pfizer, for example, insistence on indemnity, insistence on not carrying out bridging studies. Have those differences been sorted out? Have those problems been sorted out? No is the answer. But with this particular vaccine, because we've dealt with them already, we've done business with the Gamaleya Institute and the RDIF in bringing Sputnik V, the double dose vaccine, to India. So I just think it's a matter of some paperwork and some back and forth agreement, a discussion with the regulator, and this is the vaccine which I feel possibly could be the earlier ones to come. You know, I can't really say whether Pfizer is then going to agree to India insisting on indemnity, or whether Moderna is going to be workable for us. But this certainly looks workable. Also, the storage conditions, extremely important. Again, between 2 to 8 degrees, which in our situation works beautifully.
Okay, so we'll have to wait and see whether this single dose Sputnik vaccine, how soon is it going to be available here in India? Remember, Sputnik V vaccines should be available in this country almost immediately now. In fact, all of this comes in at a time when India is struggling with its vaccination drive. Here is the big number. Vaccinations in the country have reduced by almost half